On this episode of Wheel of Science, we're talking aliens. I think I'm pregnant with a little snake man.
This is Wheel of Science.
Hey everybody, welcome to Wheel of Science. I'm your host, Chuck Nice, and this is the interactive show that answers your questions about the universe. I don't answer your questions about the universe. Your very own personal astrophysicist, Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson, answers your questions. What's up, Neil?
I'm back home in New York, but I happen to, at this moment, be at New York Comic-Con.
Comic-Con, huh? Okay, what's the most interesting costume you've seen?
I saw one that looked like a very convincing alien. And then I realized, if that was an actual alien, no one would notice. They landed on the wrong day. if you're trying to visit humans, don't land on Comic-Con days, okay? Because then you'll just blend right in. You got to come on some other time. I'm just instructions for the aliens when they come visit.
There you go. Sage advice, sir. Sage advice. What time is it, Neil?
It's time to spin the wheel. Bring it on.
Pedro Duran Monteleone wants to know this. What can Drake's equation tell us about aliens?
Ooh, so Drake equation was a way to organize our ignorance of the universe when we're trying to figure out if we can communicate with intelligent aliens in space. It's named after Frank Drake. He first wrote this equation. I think it was the late 60s, might have been early 70s. You start out with the number of stars in the galaxy. And then you say, well, what fraction of those have planets? What fraction of those that have planets have life? What fraction of those have intelligent life? What fraction of those have intelligent life with technology? What fraction of those might actually be listening for us at any given moment? You start hacking away at this number, and what's left at the end is an estimate for how many civilizations are out there that you might want to talk to. And each one of these terms is an astrophysical question. Or you can back it up further and say, what is the rate that stars are being born? Because that will tell you how many stars you have to search for. So when you put all these terms together, you get an estimate of how many intelligent civilizations might be out there. And right now, in one of my recent books, we actually give the very latest calculation for this, and there's like billions, so we're good.
Do we really want to talk to billions of other people?
Yeah, I don't know if you, or tell them where you live, that would be bad. You don't give strangers who are your own species your email address, much less sending the return address to Earth out to aliens across the galaxy.
Who? Alien stranger danger. Alien stranger danger!
And Chuck, you know what the last term in the Drake equation is? It's how long the intelligent civilization might be around at all. It could be that achieving high intelligence, you now know enough how to render yourself extinct. So just because you became intelligent with technology doesn't mean you will keep that for all the rest of time. Maybe you have an expiration date.
Well, hopefully we don't push that date up further than it has to be. All right, let's move on, Neil.
Bring it on.
Don Rim wants to know this. How likely is the theory of panspermia for the genesis of life on Earth?
It's really good. If you look at microbes, certain, not all microbes, some microbes are just fine in the high radiation, low temperature, dehydrating conditions of space. And we have them here on Earth. And you say, why do you have this ability to resist this? That's not a natural force operating on your evolutionary history here. But you would need that getting through the vacuum of space. Asteroid impacts kick rocks into interplanetary space, and they travel and they land on other planets. There's some number of tonnage of rocks on Earth that actually came from Mars, came from other planets in the solar system. So panspermia is the movement of microbes from one planet to the other in the nooks and crannies of the rocks, especially in the crannies.
Panspermia. The Earth got banged by a comet and impregnated with life. It's beautiful. All right, judging from that reaction, it's time for a break. We'll be back with more Wheel of Science right after this.
Thanks to Wix for sponsoring this episode of Wheel of Science. Did you know that our fastest rockets take days to reach the moon? But using artificial design intelligence on Wix will allow you to build a website in a fraction of that time?
Yeah, like this. Let's do it.
With ADI, you just answer a few questions and your site is almost ready to go. Go to wix.com/go/StarTalk and begin your site right now.
All right, welcome back. Let's get right to another question, Neil.
Spin the wheel. Bring it on.
From Sanjeev Bhaskar, considering the environmental conditions of Mars versus Europa, where are we most likely to find aliens?
My bet is on Europa, because that has an ocean of liquid water beneath a frozen layer of ice, maybe a kilometer thick, but that ocean's been liquid for billions of years. Billions of years. And on Earth's oceans, that's where all evidence points to life having begun. So if you want to find life as we know it, we're going to look for conditions as we know it. And that would be these oceans in Europa. And then the only thing left is, if you do find life, what do you call it? And I think there's no choice but to call them Europeans.
I'm going to have a moment of silence for that joke. All right, it's caption time. We put this picture up on our page and ask for your best captions. And the winning caption is Trey McCoy. It was so big, you had to hold it like this. To this day, the best burger I've ever eaten. I just love it because it has nothing to do with astrophysics or the cosmos. It's pretty cool.
Except that burgers are oblate spheroids. And anytime you have objects in the universe that rotate very quickly, they'll spread out at the equator. And in the limiting case, you get a burger. I'm just saying.
Who knew Earth was so delicious? Hey, Neil, here is a comment from our Wheel of Science group. Stacy Radford Vincent says, hi, I've been watching Wheel of Science with my sixth grade students, and they love it. I've encouraged them to submit questions to me on the coming topics, and then I can send them in.
Excellent. So, Chuck, that means you can't be so potty mouth from now on, now that we have sixth graders watching Wheel of Science.
Neil, who do you think I learned this from? Those sixth graders. And now it's time for our poll. Our question, will we communicate with extraterrestrial intelligent life in our lifetime? Answer the poll right here. And Neil, any thoughts?
Maybe. But that's not a legitimate answer, is it? I don't know. You want a yes or no, don't you? Yeah, I would say I hope not, because if we do, they are way smarter and more technologically able than we are. And anytime that's happened on Earth, it hasn't boded well for the one who did not have the technology.
So what you're saying is you'd rather us communicate with dumb aliens.
Yes, because otherwise they will just make us their pets.
Well, that's our show, and it was a good one. As always, we have to say thank you to the one, the only, Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson. Thanks, Neil.
Thank you, Chuck. And as always, I bid you to keep looking up.
Can I stop looking up now?
Hello, Earthlings. It is time to do what you humans do best, do things on the internet. That's right, and you can do it with total design freedom. Wix is the best place to make your personal or professional website. It does everything you can possibly want it to do. Wix has industry-leading SEO tools to help you rise above the rest. Also, Wix automatically creates mobile-optimized versions of your site, so it will look spectacular on any device. And with advanced design features like animated background and scrolling effects, it'll look like you have decades of web design experience.
We could actually make your background a video.
Head over to wix.com/go/StarTalk and start designing your site today. That's wix.com/go/StarTalk and be the design star that you know you are.
Wow. Already. Look at that. Hey, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Wheel of Science. You can look down.